My piece is called Authenticity. It's not your usual, let me just say. I'm telling you once and for all that unless you return to square one and start over like children, you're going to get a look at the kingdom, let alone get in. Whoever becomes simple and elemental again, like this child, who rank high in God's kingdom, the words of Jesus, disciples, whoever simple, elemental again, like this child. Authenticity is the degree to which one is true to one's own personality, spirit, or character, despite external pressures. Children are authentic, an authenticity born out of total obliviousness to the opinions and judgments of man and culture. I learned very late in my walk my identity in the kingdom of God and the liberty that after understanding that opened my eyes to the bondage that exists in not knowing who we are as children of God. So who am I or who are you? That is an expression of God. The world and everything in it are an extension of God, a work of his hands. We are crafts molded in the hands and at the will of our potter. The soul of man is the channel through which he expresses his maker. No two souls are the same. Our experiences have shaped us, and that right there is the marker of identity. The same, but expressed differently in each of us. The way David revealed God is different from the way Paul did, or James, or Jeremiah. The word of God pays testament to this. While all led by the Spirit of God, they brought out a multifaceted God in different ways. They were authentic. If we observe truthfully, we would discover that the kingdom of God has its own culture too. Some gifts esteemed above others, some ministrations and services too. And of this poor rot, if the foot says, I am not elegant like the hand, embellished with rings, I guess I do not belong to this body. Would that make it so? If the ear said, I am not beautiful like the eye, limpid and expressive, I don't deserve a place on the head, would you want to remove it from the body? And to this he said, if the body was all eye, how could it hear? If all ear, how could it smell? As it is, we see that God has carefully placed each part of the body right where he wanted it. This entails that we don't actually discover our true selves by looking within ourselves, but by looking outside of ourselves. Paul was not concerned with sounding poetic like David. James was not concerned with seeming eccentric like John the Baptist. Their focus was on God and on reaching as many people with the gospel as possible. The giver of the gift mattered more to them than the gift itself. The giver of the ministry mattered more than the ministry itself. And so they spoke with boldness, and an authenticity burst from compassion with no regard for the opinions and judgments of man. They were fortified in faith with Jesus at the center. Living authentically means embracing the part of our soul, that is our mind, our will, our emotions, and personality plays in our ministration, not as a means to sleep peacefully knowing we are doing whatever makes us happy, but understanding that we are part of something larger than ourselves, that we owe the body of Christ a wholehearted and earnest service, one that is not simply an imitation of what we see others do, but one that stems from our hearts, from a that has God at the center. Then and only then will our service be fruitful. Only then will we materialize the will of God.